and welcome to another episode in our Delta Conveyance Quick Question video series, where we answer questions about the proposed Delta Conveyance Project, often referred to as the Delta Tunnel. Our question in this episode is, how would the Delta Conveyance Project make California's primary water supply system more resilient against a major earthquake? To live in California is to live with earthquakes. According to the California Earthquake Authority, the state experiences more than 100 small earthquakes every day. But because it can be many years between major seismic events, it's easy to forget that the question is always when, and not if, the next big one will happen. When we think about the destruction wrought by major earthquakes, we probably think first of the damage to buildings, roads, and bridges. But here in California, one of the most devastating impacts could originate right here in the Delta. That's because Delta levees have been shown to be vulnerable to collapse during earthquake simulations. Extensive levee failure in the Delta could result in the inundation of saltwater from San Francisco Bay into the Delta, and the contamination of the freshwater supply that 27 million Californians and hundreds of thousands of acres of farmland depend on. The potential scale of the social and economic impacts is hard to imagine. But why are Delta levees so vulnerable? Studies have found that the soft soil under levees in the Delta is susceptible to liquefaction, meaning the soil becomes less stable and loses its strength as a result of shaking caused by an earthquake. Other factors, including subsidence and the constant pressure from water in the channels, increase the chances of levee collapse during a major seismic event. The Delta is traversed by a series of seismic faults that make up the eastern part of the San Andreas Fault system. One of them, the Kirby Hills Fault, passes under the Sacramento River right here near Pittsburgh, and is an active fault line believed to have been the source of a magnitude 6 earthquake in 1889. Back then, the process of building the Delta's vast system of levees had barely begun. Today, there's more than 1,100 miles of them protecting Delta farmland and communities, as well as the state's primary supply of fresh water. Seismologists estimate that the Kirby Hills Fault has the potential to generate an earthquake large enough to cause some levees to fail. The proposed Delta Tunnel would be much more earthquake resistant than surface infrastructure such as levees, canals, or pipelines. Ground motion at depth is actually much less than the motion at the surface. This is because of the way shock waves propagate in an earthquake. Therefore, a tunnel at the depth proposed in the Delta Conveyance Project is at far less risk of damage. DWR has been planning for many years to address the risk of earthquakes and has developed detailed plans to guide our response and recovery efforts. Strategies include enormous stockpiles of rock and flood fight materials that can be distributed throughout the Delta to repair potential levee breaches. But as effective as these measures would be in dealing with the aftermath of a major earthquake, the Delta Tunnel would provide the most effective way to preserve that crucial link between where water is and where it's needed. Probability models have shown that there is a 72% likelihood of at least one earthquake of a 6.7 magnitude or greater striking somewhere in the San Francisco region before 2043. This fact alone emphasizes the importance of acting now to invest in modernizing California's infrastructure to protect our critical water supplies. To learn more about the Delta Conveyance Project, visit DWR online at water.ca.gov/deltaconveyance. You'll find many links to informative articles and videos about the project. Thanks for watching.